You're routing along at 160 decibels, confident and content, when suddenly you notice the router bit has let go. It comes loose in the chuck, dropped down, and made an unsightly divot in your work. You scream, "Dagnabbit!" I always swear in dagnabbits. It makes people think that I'm quaint and uncomplicated. You implore the shop gods to give you back that last 3 minutes, that last 3 inches of $9 a board foot cherry. You'll trade anything. Your Snickers bar, your pickup truck, your shop dog. Well, maybe not your shop dog. So you think to your uncomplicated self, "I must not have tightened down the collet," which is exactly the wrong thing to think. You remount the router in the bit, tightening down the collet with a 12-foot breaker bar, which is exactly the wrong thing to do. You see, 93 times out of 107, the problem has absolutely nothing to do with how tight you turn the collet. The coefficient of friction between two steel surfaces under medium pressure should be more than enough to make an ordinary router bit behave itself. What is more likely is the shank of the router bit needs a bit of polishing. Most likely it's rusty. There could be a bit of sawdust, dirt, debris of all sorts. These will prevent the collet from closing tightly around the shank of the bit. Or it could be a little grease, oil, wax. All of these will reduce the friction needed to secure the bit. Polish the shanks with a little bit of Scotch-Brite and blow out the collet with your mouth or with compressed air. In fact, I keep a piece of Scotch-Brite with the bits and polish them every time I mount them. If you suspect stray lubricants, clean the shank and the collet with a little naphtha or acetone. When you put the polished bit back in the cleaned collet, make sure that you're not tightening the collet around the fillet on the bit. This is easy to do if you're in the bad habit of just dropping the bits into the collets. The fillet is a curved transition between the shank and the cutter. You get part of that in the collet and it could easily pop loose. So instead, make sure the cutter is just a little bit above the collet. Buy some rubber O-rings and put them around the shank just to keep the fillet from dropping into the collet. That's it, problem solved. Your workshop is once again a good place to be. And you can save your dagnabbits for more important problems. I am glad to have been of service.